just has such a diversity of sounds, tapping sounds, tapping sounds, tapping sounds, because it has a lot of different components on it. It has a lot of different materials, different aspects of it that give us the options of multiple trigger sounds. So, without further ado, let's get into the reading of my Sig Sauer. I'm not gonna read the whole thing. I'm just gonna read, you know, some words out of it to soothe you to sleep, to relax you to sleep. And if listening to somebody read a Sig Sauer owner's manual is your kind of speed on like the kind of information that you want to learn, then you know, just sit back and relax and put your headphones in and just listen to me, and I'll just read some of it to you, and you'll be that much smarter about Sig Sauer M400 tread coils. So we're first gonna go through all of the warning pages. There are a lot of warning pages in these owner manuals, and of course all of them are going to say every single thing that can happen with these firearms, okay? So there, I believe, is the start on page 2, and they go all the way until they go all the way to page 19, so almost 20 pages of that warning for you to read. Now, I'm not gonna go through the warning part. This is just, number one is the safety warnings. So all of the things, Sig Sauer firearms are designed to function reliably with proper care and knowledgeable use. Right off the bat, they're telling you, hey, go get some proper training, okay? Because this, you can't just pick this gun up and just know how to use it. It's got a lot to it. It's basically what the first page says. And then it just says, safety warnings, continued and abusive handling. Basically saying, don't abuse the way that you handle this weapon. Basic rules of safe firearm handling. They just give you some basic how-to functions on what things to do, such as always treat every firearm as if it were loaded. This is kind of a staple for anybody that's ever been around a gun. You know, you're not supposed to, even if it's not loaded, you never point it in somebody's direction. You never pull the trigger just to do it, you know. And you handle it like if you were to have a bullet in the chamber of this gun. I mean, that's just basically like, that's like, I mean, I shouldn't say it's common knowledge because it's not, but, you know, it's that's a basic one. Be sure the barrel is clear of any obstruction. So the end of your barrel, this part, don't let stuff get in there. It's a no-no. Don't do that. No. Always be sure of your backstop, what lies beyond, and the safety of bystanders before you shoot, okay? Don't shoot if you can't see what's behind shooting at. Okay, don't do that. Always use clean, dry, original factory-made ammunition of the proper type and caliber for your firearm. Don't put the wrong bullets in your gun. If they're wet, don't throw them away, but don't use them. Okay, don't do that. Always wear ear protection and safety glasses when shooting. Sure. Always carry your firearm so that you can control the direction of the muzzle if you fall or stumble. So, yeah, don't carry it with one arm, okay? Never shoot at a flat surface or water. See, the water one, I've never really heard of not shooting at water. But, okay, yeah, but flat surfaces, that makes sense. And then it just, you know, blah, 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 all the things not to do. Don't do this, don't do that. And it is going further. Safety warnings, continued replacement parts. Basically telling you to only get certified replaceable parts. Alterations, get the right parts. Accessories, get the right ones. Locking devices, get the right ones. Yeah. And then this also goes on to have each individual state's like I don't really know, like they're it's like they're special rules about this gun in particular, I believe. But you know, of course, California has the biggest one. Here you go. California's got the biggest warning on there. Massachusetts is pretty. They're like, no. This handgun is not equipped with a device that fully blocks use by unauthorized users.
Goes on to tell you all the end of it.
stock. It is accessible. Okay, don't close on me, please. Stay. Okay. So, we have the butt stock. It is adjustable. We have the forward assist. The ejection port cover. The ejection port cover. The Mil STD 1913 rail, which is what you mount your scopes onto. Or your lights, or whatever you want to put on there. That is really nice. It makes a good sound. M-lock mounting point number 4. M-lock mounting point, there it is. M-lock mounting point is right under your M-lock mounting point. These pieces right here, this piece right here. And then the flash hider, this is a flash hider. Flash hider, which, you know, whenever you shoot a gun, there's an explosion that happens. Explosion happens, and that explosion has to come out of the chamber, the barrel. And so this actually helps to reduce that flash that comes out by letting it dissipate and making it less of a singular point of flash. It's more dispersed, so it's not like a singular point. And then we have the gosh, this diagram is so much more detailed than the gun. I can't really see where it's at.
Okay, so we are on this side of the gun, and we are right there.
Okay, that's the bolt catch. There's just so many little things right here. It's showing me like this. Oh, it's showing me this whole area, and I'm trying to distinguish like which buttons are which. I think this one. The name of these are, but the mounts for your scope, it just has more along the top of it, and I'm sure it has some different other aspects, some engineering aspects that are different, make it better performing. And then it goes into breaking down each individual part of the gun, each individual part. So that is the lower receiver, and it's telling you how to assemble it and reassemble it. And this is the lower receiver area, and it tells you all the basic components, all the little tiny parts that can be on the Sig M400. clean on a video because it's gonna be chaotic, you know. It's just, you know, it's a lot. And then there's more cleaning, just more cleaning, reloading, it goes on to reloading. Yeah. That is the manual. If you guys want me to actually like go through and read the manual, I will. But it's a lot, there's a lot, and it'll probably be a couple hours, so if you guys really want me to, I will. But that is my Sig Sauer in all of its parts explained. And I am still learning the names of them. And I'm learning them for you guys so that you guys can have nice sounds and no thoughts of that's not what that's called. So that you guys can just relax and de-stress.